So I'm joined here today by Chris Todd from Brighton and Hove Friends of the Earth, and today we're going to be talking about the Total Valley development, which is a massive development. It's 880 houses, isn't it, in that area? And I know that you've got some issues with the provision for cyclists and pedestrians.
Well, yeah, I mean, we've actually got issues with actually how it's laid out, because it's not laid out in a way that's going to encourage people to want to walk and cycle to either the school or the community centre or to the local shops there. And actually, it's going to be made very difficult, and it's going to put cyclists and walkers into conflict, which is neither of which are going to want that. And it's going to deter people from sort of walking and cycling to those areas and actually encourage them to think, actually, it's easier to jump in the car because I can drive anywhere and I can park anywhere.
And I should say there's a good cycle lane provision up on Bike Road all the way down. So are you calling for linkage from the Goldstone Crescent area or to Dyke Road or both? I mean, how would you improve that plan? Because we were saying off air that it is a bit unclear, the plans at the moment, which is, I know it's only outline planning, so maybe that's the case. That's the reason why. But
well, the thing is, fundamentally, if you're going to provide to encourage people to walk and cycle and to use public transport more, you've got to provide decent facilities. Now, they're providing a bus through the site, which is good. They're looking at doing pedestrian and cycle stuff, but you know, painting a bit of a cycle symbol on a pavement isn't providing cycle facilities. Making pedestrians and cyclists cross in five stages across a busy junction when a motorist can do it in one is not prioritising, you know, these sustainable forms of transport. So it's not going to encourage them to access the schools or the Hove station or whatever. It's going to make it harder for them in compared to driving. Yeah. And all the time you do that, you're going to make it, you know, unlikely that we're ever going to sort of tackle things like climate change and air pollution.
Yeah. So what are the next steps? Have you are you in discussions with the council? Because I know we're still some way off for this site to be built on. I think we were both saying about 2 years, although we don't know that for sure. But it's outline planning. It looks some way off. But so how are you going to press, you know, forward your ideas?
We've put in a formal objection on these areas, and particularly around the layout of the site, because it's put like the shops and the doctor's surgery right on one corner, well away from the rest of, you know, most of the housing. So again, making the distance further, more of a hill to climb. People aren't going to walk and cycle there. It should be creating a nice little hub around the community centre at the heart of all the housing and development, which will then draw people, you know, to it, much easier to get to, and, you know, in ways that you can do other than having to drive.
Chris, it's always a pleasure. Thanks for coming in today.
Okay. Thanks. Thank you.